And we are happy to take questions for about 10 minutes time. So you can please type in your questions and I'd be happy to answer them. I'll just take a minute to go through the questions and answer them one by one. Okay, so I have quite a few questions that I will answer. First is there a video of this webinar that will be available? Yes, it will be available in our YouTube channel. And our YouTube channel is youtube.com/tedcourse. And there are a number of videos here. So in 1 or 2 days, we expect to upload this video onto this channel. Okay, the next question is regarding the slides of this. If you can send us an email to sales@tedcourse.com or support@tedcourse.com, whoever wants this slide, they are happy to share the slides of this presentation. The next question is, how does this compare against MATLAB's 5G toolbox? MATLAB, of course, is an excellent product, and their 5G toolbox is completely focused on the link between the UE and the GNB. So there are a number of complexities in the link between a UE and the GNB that is handled by MATLAB, and they provide information in great detail because that is a link level simulator, whereas NetSim is a system level simulator or a network level simulator where the transmission happens at the level of packets, not at the level of bits and bytes. Therefore, the two are slightly different in the sense that NetSim simulates the entire network and packets flowing, whereas MATLAB simulates the link between the UE and the GNB and the signals flowing at that level. We also have a method by which you can interface NetSim and MATLAB. There are several videos and documentation available on this. So many of our researchers actually use NetSim to simulate the IP packet flow. And when it comes to the final RF transmission, rather than use NetSim's inbuilt channels, they incorporate MATLAB's channel, thereby interfacing both NetSim and MATLAB. Of course, it takes a long time to run those simulations, but that is another option available for users. Then with regards to fading and shadowing, the path loss models in 38.901 automatically factor in fading and shadowing. So the models that we have is based on the standard, and the 3GPP standard, when it gives the model, it is already factored in the model fading and shadowing. So the models come with fading and shadowing. Okay, there's a question about LDPC channel coding. Well, like I had mentioned, the 5-layer signaling level is abstract in NetSim. If you want to do at a link level simulation, then we recommend that MATLAB is a better product to do that. But if you're looking at a system wide or a network level simulation and understanding, then NetSim would be the product of choice. Okay, there are some questions with regards to flying ad hoc networks, cognitive radio, and so on. Yes, we do support cognitive radio, and we also support mobile ad hoc networks, and flying ad hoc networks is a part of that. For details on that, we request you to write to us. You can go to our website, and in our website, we have a contact us page. So you can go to this contact us page and you can send us your specific questions. Our engineering team will look at it and get back to you. Or you can also send us an email at sales@tedcourse.com or support@tedcourse.com with any R&D papers that you may have. We can study it and let you know whether the same can be done with NetSim. Okay, with regards to carrier aggregation, yes, carrier aggregation is there in NetSim. With regards to beamforming and MIMO is expected in the next release of NetSim. Okay, what's the difference between cognitive radio and new radio? Well, 5G NR is completely different from cognitive radio. Cognitive radio is standardized by IEEE 802.22, whereas 5G NR is standardized by 3GPP, and the two are quite different. Cognitive radio has to do with TV bands and how you can use TV bands for data communication, whereas the 5G NR is more about the millimeter wave bands and how that can be used for data communication. With regards to handover and mobility management, both of this is coming in the next version of NetSIM. As of now, handover and mobility are not there in 12.1. It is under development and expected for release in 12.2, maybe in June or July of this year. Customers who are currently with 12.1 will get a free upgrade as and when 12.2 is released. Okay, how can I get NetSIM software? Well, unfortunately, we don't have a version for individuals or students. Most of the time, we sell directly to our industry customers. We have a deeply discounted version for education, and you would have to kindly request your professors or the university to go in for the education version. We don't have something that we directly give to students. Since it's a high-end R&D tool, we typically deal at an organizational level. Okay, are there any patches available to incorporate various security algorithms? Yes, we have a file exchange in our website, and this file exchange has a number of patches for various security attacks, countermeasures, intrusion detection systems, encryption, and so on. So this can be used as a baseline, and customers can use this, which comes with documentation and source code, and write their own algorithms on top of NetSIM. Okay, how do I have real-time connectivity with NetSIM? That is a different module, which is called the emulator. You need the, which we can show in our website. So if you go in for the emulator as well, then what you can do is you can connect the simulator to real world, and you can send real data through the simulator. The simulator would have the virtual network, and real data will flow through the virtual network. If you have the emulation module, then you can connect NetSIM to real devices. With regards to cyber attacks and DOS and so on, it is possible, and we are in the process of developing a set of patches which should be up in our file exchange shortly. So we do have some kind of attacks and countermeasures that we have built for our other modules, which we will be adding to our 5G library as well. Is there any particular format for requesting cloud support? You can just write to your to the marketing contact, or you can write to sales@edcos.com and just mention that you are a customer and just provide some details. So it'll just be verified, and immediately you will get access to our cloud platform. Okay, can it be programmed into an FPGA chip? I mean, the answer to that is no, because here we are not simulating one particular device. Unlike in MATLAB, where you're simulating one UE or one GNB, here we are simulating network-wide, which means we are simulating hundreds of GNBs or hundreds of UEs. And therefore, there is no direct UE level code or GNB level code that is running in NetSIM. It's a network level simulation. So you can't program the NetSIM code into any particular device. We are working on secure authentication protocol for LTE and VANETs. It may be possible. We'll have to look at it and get back to you. We have had some of this kind of R&D done, but the experts in VANET and so on will look at the document and get back to you. On scalability, NetSIM can take advantage of multi-threading, which means you can run, if you have a multi-threaded processor which can handle multiple threads, then NetSIM can take advantage of that and deliver higher scale simulations. We currently don't have multi-computer or multi-processor support, but we do have multi-threading support. So if you have a very high-end processor, then you can definitely run much larger simulations when compared to running on a normal i3 or a i5 processor. Okay, does it support any programming language apart from C? Our source code comes with C, but we have interfaces with MATLAB, so you can write it as a .m file. We also have interfacing with Python, so you can write your codes in Python and you can interface that also with NetSIM. but it's just that our protocol source code comes in C. Do you have support for SDN? Yes, we have support for SDN. It is available, software defined network. Okay, why does it take a long time to simulate a 5G network? The answer for that is that we are simulating very, very high traffic loads of the order of hundreds of Mbps, or even in the multi-UE scheduling algorithm case, 1.5 Gbps of traffic. And NetSim simulates each packet, and for each packet, it logs about 40 to 50 parameters. It simulates the RF channel, simulates the time varying SNR. All of this is done, and there is, you know, millions of lines of logs that are written across the packet trace, the event trace, the metrics, the LTNR log, and so on. Therefore, compared to other technologies, the 5G simulations does take a longer amount of time. But those of you who want to optimize it, you can turn off many of the logs. In our case, we hadn't turned off. You can turn off the logging, you can turn off the plots, you can turn off the trace files, and you can run with a higher end processor, and that should give you a much faster result. WSN, WBAN, WANETs, all of that is supported. IoT, we have a long list of technologies that are supported, which we will just show you in our technology libraries page. You can see that we have basic internet works, Ethernet, Wi-Fi 802.11, ABG and AC 802.11p. Then we have some legacy protocols, MANET, advanced routing, multicasting, VLAN, access control lists, software-defined networks, IoT, ZigBee, cognitive radio, LTE, LTE advanced, vehicular ad hoc networks, then the current 5G NR, satellite communication, and then the network emulator. So all of these technologies are available, and you can choose the library that you want depending on where you're doing your R&D. In 802.11, we currently have support for AC, and AX is under development, which is expected towards the end of this year. Any further questions, if you have, you can always contact us through our webpage, or you can write to us at sales@techcos.com. And we are happy to answer anything that you have. Thank you all for your time for attending this webinar. Thank you.